Hello everyone. In this video, we will look at the various tools that are present in Adobe Photoshop. So I have taken an image here. Let me just make it large for every one of you so that you can view it clearly. I'll go to the picture and I'll write command plus 0. So this image will be zoomed so that it can fit the entire screen. So this is representing all the tools that are present here in this tool window. I can take this tool window, I can take all the tools one by one and I can work with all the tools one by one. Okay. So first of all, you should know how you can zoom a given picture and how you can move the given picture. So as you can see, this is the first option is zoom, that is Z. So if I just click on Z, so I can, there's a zoom option is there, so I can zoom the picture as much as I like. And if I want to zoom out, then I can either I can do control plus, and for zoom out I can do control minus. So this way I can zoom in and zoom out in a given picture on Adobe Photoshop. So to set the picture to the complete screen, I can just use command plus 0. So this will set the picture to be fit on this given screen. Secondly, with zoom option, I can also use a hand option. To use a hand option, you can press space and you can drag and drop the image to wherever you want to go. And secondly, you can just go to your keyboard and you can press H. With the help of H, you can get this hand option by which you can go to the various sections of the image, of the zoomed image, so that you can check the image out. So I can just press control plus 0, that is command plus 0 on my Mac. So this is the image. Now I have various tools that are present in this toolbox. The first tool here is the selection tool, and that is also called as a move tool. Now you can get to this move tool by just pressing a V. V is a shortcut, as you can see here, V is a shortcut so that you can get to this move tool. Now the main purpose of this move tool so that you can move various elements onto the screen. For example, this is the image that I have taken. Now in this image, I have various layers. I'm not introducing you the concept of the layer right now. So I have various layers here. Now I can just do a right click and I can check out which layer I want to work with. For example, I want to work with layer group 1. So I can move this particular layer according to my requirement with the help of this move tool. For example, I can move this layer in here with the help of my move tool. Okay. I can also move this logo. I can just do a right click on this and I can find that this logo is present. So gatelectures.com. So I can move this logo anywhere onto the screen, wherever I want to take it. And I can also move this given text, even though the spelling of the text is wrong. So, but still I can move this part also. Actually, the reason why I can move this, because I have various layers. So I can just go to this portion and I can go to the windows and I can click on layers, so that I can see what are the various layers that are present in this document. So there are various layers that are present and I can work with each and every layer one by one. So don't worry, I'm not introducing you to the concept of layering right now. We are just working on the tools that are present in here on the toolbox. The second tool here is the rectangular mark tool. So this is your rectangular mark tool. If you can just go here, you can get this rectangular mark tool by pressing the V button. Okay, sorry, by pressing the M button. So this is an old document. So just by pressing the M button on your keyboard, you can get to this rectangular mark tool. Now with the help of this rectangular mark tool, I can select an area which is in the form of rectangle. So just click and drag and drop to some specific area. As you can see, this is some area that is selected. Now I can do work with this particular area. For example, I want to cut it. So I can just press command plus X so that I can cut this given area. So for that, let me just get to the layers of this document. Now in this document, so in this document I can cut this layer, or I can work with some other things also. For example, I want to paint it, I want to do various things with this particular layer. I can do a lot of things with this layer. Okay, so this is your rectangular mark tool, which you can use to select some specific area in the form of rectangle. Now you have an elliptical mark tool also. If you just right click on this, you'll find there are four options here. Number one is rectangular mark tool, second is elliptical mark tool, third one is single row mark tool, and the fourth one is single column mark tool. So if you go to the elliptical mark tool, then you can select an elliptical shape like this. If you want to get a perfect square, then press shift on your keyboard, and with a shift you can just drag and drop, and you can select a given area with this particular tool, and I can work with that given area also. So this is a very easy tool, very intuitive tool, even if you have used this paintbrush software. Now in the paintbrush software also this tool is present. And then you have the next tool is single row mark tool. So single row mark tool is you can just mark a single row, and accordingly you can work with this given row also. And the same way we have single column mark tool also, where you can mark a given column like this. Okay, and the next tool here is your lasso tool. So there are three types of lasso tool. Number one is lasso tool, second one is polygon lasso tool, and third one is magnetic lasso tool. So the shortcut for this lasso tool is L. If you just press press the L button, then you can get this lasso tool from your on your toolbox. Let me show you the working of this lasso tool with a given image. I'm just opening any image that is present in my files. Let me find a good image for you. I need a JPG file, not a PDF file. So assuming that I want to work with this image, so I'm just opening both the JPG file as well as the PSD file of this image. So this image is what I've created for this PGT computer science. Now in this image, as you can see, there are various layers of this document. Let us assume I just want to work with my picture. I want to select my picture, then I'll go to this lasso tool, click on this lasso tool, and then go to polygon lasso tool. Now with the help of this polygon lasso tool, I can work with this image. So just zoom in the image with Ctrl++, and then I can go to this image here, and with the help of polygon lasso tool I can do a selection on this image. So I can just, let us say I just want to select this arm. So I can do a selection on this image like this. So as you can see, so assume I just want this arm only, I don't want anything else. I can do a selection like this. It's a very easy tool, very intuitive tool. If you can just use it for the very first time, you can get it done very easily. So for quick purpose, I just selected this arm. Now this arm is selected. Now I can work with this arm. I can do anything with this arm. I can color it. For example, I just want to make it as red color, red and black, or red and brown. And I can just go to this tool and I can work with this given arm. So I can perform various actions with this. Even I can do a cross cut. So I can just even cut this arm from its position. So in the same way, I can select a given thing onto the document with the help of this tool. In the same way, you have magnetic lasso tool. Now the benefit of magnetic lasso tool is it automatically sticks. For example, I just click on this and magnetic lasso tool is automatically sticking with it. I don't have to click anywhere. It is just finding all the sharp edges, and accordingly it is automatically selecting the document, right? Sometimes it is difficult to work with this magnetic lasso tool, but most of the time it's very easy with it, right? So sometimes it becomes very easy with this magnetic lasso tool also. So this way I can work on a given document with the magnetic lasso tool. And in the same way, we have a lasso tool. So with the help of this lasso tool also, I can work on a given document. So it is a continuous flow. For example, I can just take this, click on this lasso tool, and with this one flow I can select the area that I want to work with like this, and then I can just match it. So this way I can select a given area with this magnetic lasso tool also. So this magnetic lasso tool itself is a very intuitive tool, very easy tool to work with. Now the next tool here, as you can see here, this tool is called as quick selection tool. So quick selection tool means I just want to select something quickly. Selection, for example, let us see, from here in this document I've taken the magnetic lasso tool and I selected this document. Now I want to change some selection, so I want to do some selection. So for example, this way I can just do simple selection, quick selection tool. It also works like magnetic lasso tool, but it will select some area according to your requirement, and that area will be actually automatically selected. that area will be automatically selected from this quick selection tool. Now in the same way, I can do a selection on some specific area with this selection tool. So selection tool, it also makes selecting the things very easy. As you can see here, I just want to select something. I can use a selection tool. It will select according to the edges that is already present in this tool. So selection tool itself is very easy, very intuitive. In the same way, you have something called as magic wand tool. Now this magic wand tool is also used to select something on your image. So for example, here I just click on the magic wand tool. All the colors that are matching with this given color, they will be selected. For example, I can just go to this color and I can click on this. So all the matching colors will be selected with it. I mean, all the areas where this color is matching, I can do this with all the matching areas where this color is present. So this matching areas will be selected with this magic wand tool. Now in the same way, we have the next tool, that is a crop tool. Now with the help of this crop tool, I can crop a given image. Okay, let me just show you with an example here. Assume this is the image and this is the crop tool. I can crop this image. I can just select a smaller portion of this image. Maybe I can just select a smaller portion of this image with this crop tool like this and just click on this. And you can see here there are two options. Either you can click on this so it will crop the image, or you can just to select the another tool, it will ask for the crop. So I can just click on this and this image is cropped. So crop tool you can use to select. So just to go back, I'm going to press Command plus Z. Now in this crop tool, you have actually four different tools. One is a slice tool, second is a slice select tool, and then we have perspective crop tool, and we have crop tool. So perspective crop tool is that you want to crop something and you want to crop according to a different area. I mean, specific thing you want to crop. For example, here you can see only some specific image is cropped, and accordingly perspectively it is cropped. So according to some given angle. Okay, so then you have this perspective crop tool, which is also very useful. A part of this, you have a slice tool. Slice tool is actually used to slice to a given image. So I can just like you are using a slicing of your just you slice a cake, in the same way you slice this document. So with the help of the slice tool, I can slice or I can crop to a given document. And this slice tool actually used when you are using your web development. So in terms of web development, if you want to create an entire page and now you want to slice to some specific area of that web page, then you can use a slice tool for that. Okay, so I'll show you the working of slice tool later on. Whenever it is required, I'll show you the slice tool. I'm just discussing a specific basic tools that you are going to use in your day-to-day life in your Photoshop. So the next tool here, that is the frame tool. So frame tool is used so that you can place something onto that particular frame. For example, let us say I just want to place something here. So I'm just going to select a frame here. After selecting a frame, I can put some image onto this frame. So let us say I just want to use this image onto this frame. So I can drag and drop that image on the frame. So the image, entire image will not show up, only the part where I selected the frame, that part will show up. Okay, so I can just work with this given frame. The entire image will not show up here. So according to the frame only, I can select how much part of the image I want to use with the help of this frame tool. Now after this, we have eyedropper tool. Actually, eyedropper tool is used to select the color. So if you just click on eyedropper tool, you can see the color here, it will change. For example, I just click on this and make sure that you can see the color here will change. So this color will change with the help of this eyedropper tool. So this eyedropper tool is used to select a given color, as you can see here. So I can just select any specific color. I can go to any specific color. I can get all this, even hash code values of that particular color with this eyedropper tool. So this way you can use this eyedropper tool to select an image or some specific color. Now in this eyedropper tool here, you have six tools that are present. That is 1, 2, 3 count tool, note tool, ruler tool, color sampler tool, 3D material eyedropper tool, and eyedropper tool. So as you can see, ruler tool is very specific. So it is just used to do a ruling. I mean, just like scale you are using. So it is just like a scale. So you can measure something with the help of this ruler tool. So how you can measure? So as you can see here, in this ruler tool, there is some toolboxes present here where it is showing the X dimension. this is y dimension, this is the width, this is the height, this is the angle, and this is the latitude. For example, here I can just measure from here to here what is the length of this. I can select these two portions and then go to here. So from x point on my screen, it is starting from pixel location 404.21 to the pixel location 250.35, and the width from here to here, the width is 656.70 pixels, and the height here is 436.47 pixels, and the angle that I've used here to measure is -33.6 degrees. In the same way, you can use the ruler tool to measure the width of various documents. I can just assume I can use angle here, so I'm using angle as 0.2 degrees, and so height deviation from here to here is -2.24 degrees. To find, and width here is 660 pixels. So this way I can use this ruler tool to measure the documents. In the same way, there's a note tool, that is, I want to place a note here. So this note tool is only available to you. I can just place a note here, for example, hi, this is a note. So if you want to create some portion of the image and you want to write a note for this, then you can select a note tool in this way. In the same way, you have a count tool. So count the number of objects in an image. For example, here you can see what is the number of objects. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I can just count the number of objects that is an image with the help of this count tool. It's a very intuitive tool, very easy tool. Now here the next tool is spot healing tool. So spot healing tool is sometimes used when you want to heal some particular spots with the help of some document. I'll show you the spot tool. For example, I can work with the signature of some person. I can work with various things in a document. I'll show you how this spot tool is going to work. So let me just make a second part of this video where I'm going to start with the spot tool and what is the working of the spot tool.